Well, hi folks, this is Darren with My RV Works. We sure do get a lot of questions from you guys on how different systems work in RVs. And what I'd like to share with you for the next few minutes is Darren's version on how a battery works. Okay? So we have these batteries in our RVs, and maybe we don't understand exactly everything about them. But I'm going to give you my best visual on how a battery works. Now, is this technically correct? Absolutely not. It involves fish, it involves a lake. It involves electric eels and a dock. So this is not even close to a real world. Well, this is technically how a battery works. But if you go with this analogy, you won't get in trouble and it'll get you where you need to go, okay? And we can have a discussion around a campfire when we meet one day and discuss the intricate details of solfation, okay? So let me take you to my lake, okay? So what I have here is a beautiful lake. Oh, it's a stunning lake. It's filled with distilled water. Totally distilled water, and I have stocked it with electric eels. And so I don't know how to draw an eel, but I'm just gonna say that's an eel, that's an eel, that's an eel, that's an eel. I need to get a lot of eels in here, okay? The lake is full of electric eels. Bunches and bunches of electric eels, and they're beautiful. You don't wanna touch them because they'll electrocute you, but you can look at them, and they're really pretty. But I have a lake filled with electric eels, and they're glowing, and it's stunning, and it's beautiful. Now, on my lake, I have a pier that goes into the water. And maybe you want to go electric eel fishing. So we're going to draw a pier. Maybe it's a wooden pier, maybe it's not. But we're going to have these little pier going out into the water. And what do all piers have to hold them up? Pilings, okay? So we're going to have a piling that goes down into the water holding up my pier. We like this, don't we? Yes. That's actually not a bad drawing, if I do say. Put a little puffy cloud, little squirrel. I'm channeling my new my Bob. What's his name? Bob Ross. Okay. So here I have a lake. Here I have eels, and I have a pier. Okay. But wait, there's more. On all of my piers, I have lights. Okay. I have these lights on these pilings because I want to illuminate my pier. And maybe running up to the here, I have myself a house. Beautiful little house. Puffy cloud, little squirrel. We love you, Bob Ross. So I need to turn on a blender because I'm wanting a strawberry fruit smoothie. Sounds really good. Yeah. So what do I do? I flip a switch. I flip a switch, and basically, I now put a call out to the eels, and whatever eel's closest, it's like a differential in a Ford 9-inch rear end. Whichever eel is closest, he sticks himself to the piling. Here's an eel that's closed, here's an eel that's closed, and they stick themselves to the piling, and that eel that was glowing gives off his charge. He's not glowing anymore, and he gives off his charge, and he runs himself up the wire to turn on the power in my house. Now, we did a video that I invite you to watch on the differences between AC and DC converters and inverters. And if I was going to run my smoothie machine on AC and I'm getting it from the eels, I would need an inverter. But let's just say that everything's DC. Maybe I'll forget the smoothie. It's a light. I'm turning a light on in my house. Okay. So as long as my light is on, more and more eels get drawn to the pilings, giving up their charge. So now I've got a dead lake. Sooner or later, my lake will be dead. Still has eels in it. They're still alive, but they have no charge. They're dead. They're not dead. They're not glowing. They gave up all their electricity that they carried with them, making themselves beautiful and iridescent. Kind of like, what was that movie, Avatar, with everything glowing. So we have a lake full of eels. I need power. The eels give up their power, feeding my house. And now all of a sudden, my lake is depleted of electric eels. And my light goes off. No different than if I had a flashlight and I left it on, eventually the flashlight would die. It would deplete. Now, if it's a rechargeable battery or a rechargeable lake, then what do I need to do? Over here, I have a crank that I'm cranking and cranking and cranking and cranking. Maybe there's a pretty little waterfall that feeds us. I don't know. But basically, I have to reverse the flow of electricity. It was coming this way to turn the light on. Now I need to reverse it going into this way, and all these eels that were stuck on my pilings, they like like the movie Batteries Not Included. Okay, remember where they plugged into the toaster thing and they were running extension cords up to the roof of the house? Gotta watch Batteries Not Included. Epic, epic, epic movie from the 80s. Awesome. So all of a sudden, my eels get juiced back up again and they're happy to swim back in my lake. Do you see the brilliance of my genius plan here, of my design? So the lake is the battery, right? This distilled water, and the electric eels is all the electric charges within the battery, and the pilings are the plates within the battery, and then these two points right here are the positive and negative posts on my battery, and then the battery draws the power, the positive and negative anode cathode of my battery draws the juice, and when the battery gets depleted, we reverse the charge, feeding it back. So if you can remember the eels in my lake and the pilings, then you have a wonderful concept on what a battery. Now, how many times could you do this? Hundreds and hundreds of times. You could keep feeding the eels, taking them out. The worst thing you could do is let your lake freeze, because if you let your lake freeze, if you let your battery freeze, the eels die. Don't let your battery die. Don't let your battery freeze. Don't let your lake freeze. The other thing to note is the longer that eel stays on the piling, he's going to start to barnacleize, isn't he? And you might put power back out, but he might be missing his dorsal guiding feather. He might be, that's from Monty Python, he might be missing his a fin or a flipper. Why? Because he stayed on the piling too long. Why? Because you didn't charge a battery right away. You let that battery stay dead for a long period of time, and they call that sulfation in battery parlance. In this analogy, it's barnacleization. Okay. So the longer the eel stays on the piling, because we never fed him the juice to get him back off the piling, the longer he stays. Now, if I started with 1 million eels, maybe I only have 500,000 eels. And of those 500,000, you got some that are limping around, you know, because their flippers got stuck, barnacleized. So from that lesson, we understand that as you deplete your battery, charge it back up as soon as you can. Don't let it stay dead. Charge it back up. Keep your eels happy. The next takeaway from this is if I turn on one light, not a problem. Eels will be attracted to this, attracted to this, attracted to this. But if I turn on all the lights at one time and put a massive load on all the circuit, then these eels are going to crash the deck, kind of like in hockey. They're just going to crash the net. And the harder the eel hits my piling, it's going to embed itself into my piling and might damage it. So you can hurt a battery by doing a massive inrush to that battery. So that is to say, if I've got my battery and all of a sudden I am demanding a tremendous amount of power out of this battery all at one time, I could be doing damage to that battery for the same reason as the eels hitting this, okay? So we don't want to do a massive inrush on a battery, and we don't want to do, we don't want it to stay depleted for a very long period of time. So if we can understand the eels and the pilings and the dock and the thing, we can have our batteries maintained very, very well. So as the water in my lake depletes, let's put some more water back in it. There are, back in the 70s and 80s, we used to put acid in the batteries. Now I don't think that's necessary. Also, batteries that are in a plastic case can go directly on the ground. A lot of folks had the older style batteries, they would not put them on the ground directly. Almost all new batteries these days that are in a plastic case can go directly on the ground, no problem at all. If I were to take a battery, a brand new battery, just came off the line, that thing is as charged as you can possibly get it, and I were to take it out to an island in the middle of nowhere over a period of time, maybe even a couple of 6 months to 9 months, it will deplete. Just the eels will just deplete themselves. And so it is good to take that battery and always give it what's called a maintenance charge or a trickle charge or things like that. So I did want to share this beautiful picture with you. And hoping that it helps you with your analogy on batteries. I might reference this from time to time as I'm talking on future videos. I'm like, hey, go watch that battery, that video I did on eels. So if we could visualize this, then I really think it'll help you understand a little bit more about our batteries, what sulfation is, why do we keep them charged, what massive inrush will do to them. And if I think of other things to add to this, I certainly will. So hope this helps you guys. Give us a thumb up if it did, and share your questions with us, because this came from one of the questions you guys asked. So let's jump out of this and not waste any more of anybody's time. So thanks. Give us a thumb up. Happy camper. Say my every works. And hopefully you can enjoy your lake with the eels, and we can all see each other down the trail. Thanks for watching. Bye.